and I started my business 10 years ago. So you start small and you're getting up. Eh?
You're a young trainer.
I'm a young, yeah. I'm 35 years old, so I have some time left. Maybe because we search now for the bigger. We had the better horses, of course, last year already with Clint W. Boko winning the Dutch Derby. But before that, we had Jaras, who went later on to Pierre-Levesque, and he also won the German Derby. That's about 3-4 years ago. But you know, like everyone, I also had to build on the successes. You build on your system every day. You know, you learn every day. You learn about. Maybe the successes which are coming now has to do with the learning I did before, because you have to learn what kind of horses have to race in what kind of races, what the competition is in some sort of races. You know, sometimes you see a race and you just think, yeah, well, maybe that's too heavy, and if you just try, you find out that sometimes it just works, and also the other way around. When you think you have a nice race and just put in your horse, and you see the competition is very heavy, and you find yourself ending up on the end of the field. But that's the way you have to learn. Eh? That's the way racing works.
And you have a famous driver.
Yeah, I have a very good, very talented driver, Robin Bakker, which. Who's working here, and we work together, and that works out really perfectly, because Robin is a very talented driver, a young guy who's very very relaxed, and who sees everything in a race, you know, and he has the same ambition as me. He wants to get up to the highest level, and well, that's if that comes together, that can work out really, really well. This is Lady Ellen. She won the what we call the Troostlauf from the German Filly Derby. That's for horses which didn't qualify for the big final. She's not a very easy horse. She makes breaks very, very fast, but she's a fast horse. And she's going to race this winter in Wolvega. I think she's going to get some extra money there. Fast horse, not so easy. Here we have Duenna Boko. She's going to qualify today for racing, and she's going to race all winter. She's a very talented horse with a lot of speed, and I think she's going to win some PMU races this winter.
Wolvega.
Wolvega. And the last of those three horses is Amazonie du Fer. She has been racing in France 2 times, but made a break, and then she went last time to Gelsenkirchen and Trotteur Français race. She was second. It was a Trotteur Français race for Trotteur Français, who didn't win 60,000 euros. So she was heavy in the race, but she was second. She's racing today. She has to learn the racing a little bit, but. After that, she's going to go back to France to make some French races, and also racing in Wolvega in the Trotteur Français races. I think she can win one or two races this winter in Wolvega. Aida Boko here in the middle. She's just new in her stable. She's going to race today, the first time for our stable. She's in the highest class. She's going to race this winter here in Wolvega in the highest class, and maybe if we can find some races, and if she's going well, we can race her in Vincennes this winter. She's a horse that can make some classifications in French races as well, I think. She has a nice amount of money, and she has 120,000 euros, so should have some races over there. She's engaged in a race on the 16th of September. Further on this today, here in Wolvega, we see the first race of Tokyo Hotel Hall. He's an Andover Hall son. He's going to race all winter here in Wolvega, also as well the PMU races. And well, he still has to learn a lot, but I think he also can make some good money this winter here in Wolvegem. Then we have Deborah Bokum. She was third in the Dutch Valley Derby. She's going to continue racing this winter, and I think she also can make some money this winter in Wolvegem.
Not in France?
No, she has two less prize money. She has to, because the purse on the Dutch Trotting Derby was not that high. She has only won 6 or 7 thousand euros. I have this winter for Wolvega Diamond. It's a gelding, just 3-year-old. He showed a lot of potential in spring. He won a race in 16 in Gelsenkirchen. He was second here in 15.8 in Wolvega. But he couldn't get his trot together in on Duinlicht in the Netherlands. And so he, it didn't work out for him in the Dutch Derby, but he was very talented. So he's taking a small break now for 4 or 5 weeks. And then he starts training, and we see him back in December when the PMU meetings start. And I think he's really going to win 4 or 5 races this this winter on the PMU racing. It's Denise F. Boko. She was second in elimination of the Dutch Trotting Filly Derby. And didn't work out for her in the final. She was missing some strength, and she's taking a small break now also for 4 or 5 weeks. And then she's going to come back, and she starts racing again November, December. Just still has the Breeders' Crown, and also left the PMU racing in Wolvega. So that's about the horses that we have for this winter, which bettors can follow on during the meetings in Wolvega.